We have seen that we have discussed two topics till now. Now we are starting with the third topic for this session. The two topics will help us in understanding the third topic better. And the first topic you have seen is that why do we do capital structure? Keeping in mind that the value of the shareholder should be maximized based on EPS. Then you went to the second topic, you saw what is capital structure all about. Now you have also seen that capital structure just deciding the proportion of various sources of finance. Now keeping in mind the ultimate objectives are met. There are two objectives of capital structure. First is that shareholders' value should maximize, or the value of the firm is increased. Right? That is the ultimate objective of finance as well, and the objective of capital structure, value of the firm should increase at the end. Now we have studied cost of capital under acquisition, if you remember, that is financing decision. So second objective of capital structure is that our cost of capital is minimized as such. See, we want to save money. And what is cost of capital? Return we need to pay to an investor. So when we, our capital structure will increase when we pay less return to an investor. So we all want to save money. So pay less return to an investor and similarly maximize the value of a firm. These are the two objectives of an optimum capital structure. So when we decide a capital structure, we focus on this. Whether the cost of capital is reduced and whether the shareholder's value or the value of the firm has increased. Keeping this in mind, we come to the various forms of capital structure. Now, how can you raise money? You can raise money only through equity shares, or you can raise money through equity shares and preference shares. You can raise money through equity shares and debentures, or you can put all these sources together. Some through equity, some through preference shares, and some through debentures. So you can normally in practice, if you see the four forms of capital structure, how do you raise money? But whatever source you go for, keep in mind the objectives of capital structure are met. So what is an optimum capital structure? The optimum capital structure is the capital structure or the combination of various sources, be debt and equity or preference, whatever you go for, which leads to the maximum value of the firm. That is the optimum capital structure. And it is that capital structure, you can say, at which the cost of capital is minimum and the value of the firm is maximum. Your objectives of the firm are met, and when the objectives of the firm are met, that is an optimum capital structure. You can go for any combinations you feel good for you. Be equity or preference, be equity and debentures. But we have studied in today's illustration that the shareholders' wealth increases the most when you have more obligations. But is it good or bad? See, when you have more obligations in your capital structure, maybe shareholders' wealth is increasing today, but what happened tomorrow? You saw what happened to Sahara recently. Since last year, the case is in court since 2014 because they issued a debenture. Okay, it's a wrong debenture, whatever. It's not legally, you could say, in India to be allowed as such. Whatever. See, a debenture, Roy landed up in prison. And the case is going on for more than a year now. The selling of property all over the world. Now, with interest, if you see, debenture holders get interest. The amount is tuned up to so much crores of rupees. Now, if you see, company cannot run out of debenture. It's a liability for a company. So, liability is risky. It's okay, I agree. It increases the shareholders' wealth, but it also increases the risk part. So, how do we raise the money now? This is what capital structure we'll be seeing. So, if debentures increases the shareholders' value, they also increases our risk. So, which capital structure we should go for? What is an optimum capital structure? We'll be discussing in the next session.